The idea of quantum computing goes back to Richard Feynman, who's actually a very famous physicist from the US. And he was originally motivated from a rather physical question. So he wanted to know if I wanted to figure out what happens to some physical system, some quantum mechanical process, after some time, say 5 minutes. Maybe to make this prediction, it's easier if I actually also had a quantum computer. So if I have a quantum computer, I can maybe simulate this quantum mechanical system, figuring out what it does after 5 minutes, more efficiently than on a classical machine. There are already some very small quantum computers. They don't work with very many quantum bits, but they do work with a very small number of quantum bits, and they can perform some operations. So it is probably conceivable that the first quantum computers that will be built can solve only very specialized tasks. So I cannot program this quantum computer to solve any problem, but it can only solve very specific problems that it's built for. So you can imagine this is somewhere similar to how classical computers started. So already 150 years ago, people started building machines, in fact back then mechanical machines, really with moving wheels and levers, that could only solve particular problems, like maybe they could only add numbers less than 50. So classical computers, of course, had a long time to evolve since these simple mechanical machines. And I guess today everybody has them. You have them in your pocket, in your phone. So you can probably imagine that quantum computers, well, until we kind of fully understand how to build them, it may also take some time.
Stefanie, why do you choose to do research on non-existing machines?
Well, that's a perfectly fair question. But what motivates me is maybe more of a physical question. What can efficiently be computed in nature? How quickly does something take? How much time in principle does it take me to solve a particular problem? So if you ask about what can nature do, and we think that nature works according to the laws of quantum mechanics, then this is a question: what can a quantum computer do? How efficient is a quantum computer, and not how efficient is a classical computer?